All right, folks, most of you know my next guest from his celebrity interviews on Howard Stern's nationally syndicated radio show. Tonight, he's here with his band to perform a song from his self-titled debut album. Please join me in welcoming back our friend, Stuttering John. It sounded very good.
Thank you very
great.
Much. Thank you very much.
How's the album doing right now?
The album's doing really well, you know. You know, we're doing doing good, you know? We're still getting played on MTV a lot, although MTV, the thing now is to play a lot of depressing videos, you know? Everyone's got to be depressed and be abused, you know? Rotten child. I mean, I had a rotten child I'm a stutterer, you know? I remember once I was, you know, I used to play football.
Uh-huh.
And I was the guy who ran in to bring in the plays. Crucial game. I know.
Who gave you this job?
The coach was a retard, but anyway.
Okay, all right.
So I'm the one who's bringing the plays. Crucial game, crucial time. So I run in there, and I'm like, so the quarterback's like, come on, spit it out. And they threw the flag, and we got penalized for delay of game.
Oh.
And we lost the game. So, you know, my childhood sucked. So, yeah, okay. Stone of face, skip, they call me everything.
But you overcame all that.
You know, I ain't like Roseanne, you know. Well,
she actually says words in there.
I was raped when I was 3 months. Yeah. Okay.
No, I've heard you point out that other singers who stutter have Mel Tillis. Career, country singer.
Yeah, Mel Tillis probably the only, you know, stutter I know in music. I actually met him the other day, and I had a 5-minute conversation with him. It took 2 hours. Good guy, though. Good guy.
Yeah.
I've been playing for a long time. Like you hear these guys, you know, Katie Sagal, you know, actress, gone music, you know, Sherman Helmsley. But I've been playing for a long
Sherman
time.
Sherman Helmsley is good.
Oh, come on.
He is a top-notch musician.
I love him on the Jeffersons, but, you know, the guy can't play the guitar. You know what I'm saying?
You haven't heard guitar playing until you've heard Sherman Helmsley play guitar. His Ode to Wheezy is the best song I've ever heard. Best damn song. Now, you, last time you were on the show, you called it. You said Howard's not going to run for governor.
I did.
Said the reason's going to be because of financial disclosure, and you called it.
I called it.
You called it. It's true.
Yeah, like I said, you know, they'll be mutiny in the studio with Jackie the Joke Man. Forget it. You know, hey, come on, give me some money, Howard. But actually, I would love for Howard to be governor, because I always want to be like the Stephanopoulos of the campaign, you know. I've been pushed around by so much press. I would love to be like, yes, no, I'm sorry, Dan Rather, but Hustler magazine, we'll talk to you for this one. I mean, the ultimate, you know...
Ultimate high.
Yes.
All right, now, speaking of interviews, have you done any celebrity interviews lately? Did you, anything you wanted to ask LaToya? She left.
But... Oh, LaToya, I know, I thought she was going to be on the set with me.
I know, she took
I wanted
off.
To ask her why Michael didn't moonwalk backwards to avoid his father's punches. But... Oh, come on, lighten up there! It would have been fun.
You should have told me that one before we started the show. Yeah. What about, who have you talked to lately?
Roseanne hates Howard, so I recently asked Roseanne Barr which personalities of hers hates Howard, you know? She's, you know. Eddie Van Halen. Uh-huh. This is one that, you know, it's hard for me to interview, you know, my idols. Eddie's one of my idols, and I remember at an MTV press conference, I said, Eddie, since you name your son Wolfgang, will you be naming your daughter Coyote Face? And he got so pissed off, man.
Now, why did he get angry at that?
Yeah, you know.
What's his problem?
I don't know.
Some people just can't. Did you talk to Mike Wallace? Did I hear?
Oh, Mike Wallace. Yeah, that was the best one because he really hates me, especially now.
You like it when they lose their temper and get mad. Obviously,
like
that's the best one.
I mean, sometimes I like it when they have fun, but like, you know, Mike Wallace, I just asked him, you know, how could a guy his age still have pimples? and he got so pissed off.
Oh, man, wow.
Don't understand.
Does he?
Yeah, he's got a crater face, man. Ice pick face, you know.
Oh.
I'm sorry for all you blemished people out there.
Gonna have the pages hand out Stridex. All right, you brought some clips. Is this true?
Yes.
You brought some. Does this need any setup, or does this go without saying? This is you. This is your art.
Yeah, this is my art. You know, this is my other art.
This is your other art. You got the music, and you have asking celebrities embarrassing questions.
Yeah.
All right, let's roll these clips. And watch the art.
So tell me, where is your friggin' hat? Were you afraid that Ferraro would get cramps in office? Do you wear a hat when you're making whoopee with your wife?
Oh no, not at all.
Did you ever put your hat on backwards?
Probably not.
Did anyone ever try to knock your hat off your head?
All right, this is a really serious question.
All right.
What kind of material do you enjoy? What kind of material do you enjoy reading in the toilet bowl?
Were you ever naked behind the podium on a bandstand?
Guys, did you ever throw up and get big chunks in your beard? Did you ever smell the inside of your hat?
No.
Actually, Tom Landry's a good sport about the whole thing. He let you take his hat?
Yeah. Well, no, he actually didn't do it. You know, it's so funny because every question was directed at his hat, and that's the one time he doesn't wear his hat.
That's when you stumble upon him. All right, I want to get in one thing. You made a cameo, too. You're on the move. You made a cameo in Airheads.
Yeah,
right?
This movie Airheads. You know, a couple of guys from Saturday Night Live.
Yeah, Adam Sandler's in it.
And Chris Farley. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I made a cameo. You know, they wanted me to act, but it's pretty easy to act because my line was I used to masturbate constantly, and you know, the shoe fits. But it was fun.
That's a great line to have.
Yeah, actually. Yeah.
Did you have to write it on your hand or anything?
I'm sure it would be easy for you too.
Ah, yes, thank you. God love us both.
You, I know it's easy.
What do you mean, used to? Used to?
All right.
I remember, you know, being a stutterer.
We had such a classy show going right there.
Being a stutterer, I remember once when I was a little, kid, you're all insecure in high school. I remember this beautiful girl. I love this girl. She comes up to me and she goes, and, you know, I have a trouble saying my last name because, you know, M's are very difficult. So she comes up to me and she goes, hi, what's your name? And I go, John. Mm-hmm. And she goes, John what? I go, Melendez! She goes, all right, okay. They split.
That ruined everything.
So believe me, I know all about masturbation.
Well, a nice note to end on, John. John, everybody, thanks for coming. Thanks for playing.
Thank you.
Folks, we'll be right back.